Hello everyone, I'm Martin, from the Maker School. Remember our last video about virtual production? If you don't, or you haven't had the opportunity to watch it, jump on it at the end of this one. For a brief sum up, let's say this place is an usual set, surrounded by LED walls, which are projecting images and then captured by a real camera. Its purpose is to simplify and add more control to a movie shoot and to have VFX on set for the whole crew. Today, we'll try to understand how to relate the virtual world to the real one. First things first, how do you produce those incredible images you see on the LED screens? You could have recorded something on the other side of the world and project it on the screens, or use video footage bought online, who knows. But it's not how the industry decided to work. Instead of doing that, they create 3D environment to allow the camera to move inside the scene and film from different point of view without revealing you're filming a giant TV. But what tools do we have for this? Is there something available today to create 3D environment and render them in real time, making moves and modifications possible? Yeah, dude. It's called video games, and it exists since Pong. We are not exactly using video games, but the software the developers used to create them. Let's introduce you to the Unreal Engine, the virtual rendering software responsible of Fortnite, Borderlands 3, or even some NBA 2K games. And it's a free software, guys, jump on it. So basically, what you just have to do is to dive in the software, buy a 10x4 meters LED screen, plug it to your old junk PC, and it's render. Et voilà. Okay, just joking. It is an insane amount of work at this scale, but you could really do it on your small TV or your computer screen, with toys as the main role of the movie. We are planning on doing something like this for you guys. Back to business. We just have the software on our computer and nothing to put in. Don't worry, you can find assets online, with companies doing photo scans or 3D modeling for you. Of course, real 3D artists would create their own designs and objects according to the production design of the movie. But like you, we forgot our $1 million wallet in our bedroom this morning. Once you drop those objects on your scene, you can light it with precise instruments that will calculate light trajectories and rebounds in your scene. You have now a real looking set extension on your LED screens. Then you'll see you have one problem. It's like you're filming a theater screen. Nothing moves with you when you move around the scene with the camera. Let us introduce you to the parallax. It's a phenomena you all know. Remember, when you were a kid and you were going back home in the family car with your parents, yes, you see where I'm going. The moon was following you. Or maybe not. It's just that it's so far away that compared to it, you're not really moving. The street lights, however, moved really fast closer to the car. It's something we all see every day, without putting a name on it, but it's important for us in order to conceive reality. And that's where 3D rendering software can help us. They are precisely created to emulate those type of phenomena for a better immersion in a video game. So okay, now we can move the camera wherever we want. That's nice. But how does Unreal know where I am, in order to synchronize it to the screens and have the right parallax? And here again, it's a video game solution. Ever heard about HTC Vive? It is a cheaper option compared to a lot of tools available on the market. But Julian and Bruno's stage is being upgraded in the next months, and they are working on a very new tech. HTC Vive was an easier tool to begin with and create the very first virtual production project here in France. Similar to your best video game nights on your HTC Vive, you have to set your base stations around your set to allow the Vive to be tracked by the software, in this case, SteamVR. It is a temporary solution, because it is not optimized for this purpose, and cannot work with a lot of people on the stage, because the base station couldn't see the Vive tracker. To have precise values on your stage, you have to create what we call in France a point P, that is a reference point in your stage space. The Vive will tell you that it is 5 cm on the right of the point, with a 20 degree angle, and SteamVR will traduce all those informations every second to the Unreal Engine to match the perspective with the camera. You are now totally immersed in a new kind of 3D world. If you enjoyed our content, please consider subscribing.